Hi everybody, my name is Spammers and welcome back to Sherlock Holmes, the Devil's Daughter. In the previous episode, somebody tried to kill us. Oh yes, so we had to find out who it was before they could finish the job. Also, Miss Alice, the next door who rather likes my daughter, she's a little bit psycho, so we're keeping an eye on her. What's going to happen now? I haven't a clue! So, without any more stalling, let's begin!
Holmes, you simply have to face up to it. You need to have a serious discussion with Kate about her origins.
I can't.
No more excuses. She will learn soon enough that Alice is leaving. This other hidden secret. She will not forgive you.
She does not need to know why.
No? So she will blame you for Alice's departure. Is that what you want?
No, I certainly... It's as Kate said, I always do the wrong thing where she's concerned.
Now look here. I'll take care of your case once we're back at Baker Street.
Cabby, why have we stopped?
The road to the square is blocked, sir.
Why?
There's been a bad road accident.
Oh, splendid.
Oh, splendid. Death and murder aside, we're going to be late. Oh, my. Dear God, Watson.
There may be injured who need help.
Yes, Watson. Go! Save the day! You can be the lead for a change. Oh, this man, he's on the floor. He's not feeling very well.
His pupils are constricted, but they are moving. He is still alive.
He's like, oh, my God, help me. My arm hurts.
He has stopped breathing. There's no heartbeat.
Dear
I must
God.
Act quickly to save him.
His eyes are moving, but there's no heartbeat. Oh, here we go. I can do this. Live! Don't die on me! And... Live, you bastard! Live! Hold! And then... Don't you die on me! Get me this heart pedal thingy that George Clooney uses! Would you just live already? This is taking too long. I have other people to help. Where's Sherlock? He should be doing this. I don't want to play anymore. Okay, I think he's gone. Doctor, you did all you could. Give up on him. He's never going to amount to anything anyway. Look at his clothes. He's clearly not meant for Parliament.
Thank goodness. This man will live.
He looks like it. He's like... He's alive.
Don't just stand there. Do something.
Oh, crap. Oh, well, Holmes? Are you? Oh, death from above. You must go now. Move.
Please move to a safer area, sir.
You sure told him. Doink. Help! Help! Yes! Boom! I saved your life. That's 10 pennies. Thank you.
I would have died if not for you.
Well, don't mention it. You there!
Please!
No visible wounds, not injured. But his leg is trapped. Leg underneath. Trapped leg. So can I move the cart? Cab has heavy weight. Okay. So... Oh, there's more to be seen. Oh, we can do the whole thing with this doodad. Yeah, but we have a pole. Can be used as a lever. Yes, we have all we need here. So, do your business.
Can't lift it with my bare hand.
Yeah, pick up that. That's a clever Sherlock. And then doink it up. Doink it! Oh, I need to do the finger click. Oh, the pain! You are free, good sir. Hobble off. I'd be with a save. You there.
Don't worry. I'm okay.
That's great. Watson, you need it. Oh, jeez, I'm running out of time. People are dying.
I'm a doctor. Will you allow me to look at your shoulder?
People are on the floor injured, and this guy's my shoulder hurts. Oh, okay, right. Oh, yeah, I'm going to rotate this, and doink. And confirm. Nope, no skipping. Yes, that one. Doink. Yes, you're alive and well.
Thank you for your help.
Many days pleasuring yourself to be had ahead. Sherlock, what's up with this man? Dear God, he's on the floor. Look around. Examine him. Shake him. Wake up, my friend. Wake up. There's been an accident. Please wake up. Nope. I'm going to wake up one more time. Nope, not having any of it. Examine.
I see no visible injuries.
Okay. Oh, yeah, that woke him up.
Oh, my head.
Yeah, I'm not going to tell you what was in that pot. Watson, you're the man for the job here. Jeez, get out of the way. Oh, shit, there's somebody in here. Fuck! I was too slow and may now die. I thought everyone would have equal amount of time. Like you and there. Oh.
There must be a way to save.
Please! Help!
I'd better call Holmes.
Oh, Holmes. Oh, jeez. Holmes, this one's only what you can do. I'm running out of time. Death awaits him. Oh, yes, there's a door. Missing the door handle. Cannot open. Break the glass. On the floor is, yes. A Phalanx. Construction site. Yes. The man is unconscious, requires evacuation. Post haste. Can I... The window. Please be the window. Could be broken. Yeah.
I know it could be broken. I can't select it. Oh my god. I must save the person, but I can't click on anything. Yes, that on the floor. Back to this. Oh, door hinges could be broken. I'm on it. Right, good sir. Don't you dare die on me. I've come too far, done too much deducing. Boink. Here we go, and swing, better, better, swing. Whoop, boink. Yes, oh, the finger time again. I'm gonna make a lady happy one day with this finger. And then oh, again. Boink. Fence lighting up. Oh, and again. Oh, come on, be done with it already. Swing. Oh, the finger, the pain is real, the pain is real. Pull it open. We have not but seconds to go. Oh, really? Just yank the bastard off. Oh, and he just tumbles out. Hey, buddy. Jeez, he just... What? Where did he go? I don't know. Somebody in here? Why is that a ticking time bomb of death? I don't know. Oh! That's how the guy would have perished. Under luggage of fire.
Over here!
I already saved you once. Oh, S to drag. Come on, Watson, couldn't you have done this? Yes, well done, he's alive.
Thank you for saving me.
Oh, thank you for saving me. Now this guy over here. You, sir, what's
Please
the matter?
Help me, my leg.
My name is Dr. Watson. Let me examine.
Let me introduce myself. There's loads of time to talk. Right, ankle
There's
hurts.
Some extreme bruising.
I think...
Somebody. No bones appear to be broken. I think that an improvised bandage will do for now.
That's really
One moment,
important.
And I'll fetch what I need.
Really? Could he not wait?
Now, let me apply the bandage.
Let me apply the bandage. Okay, we're going to make a stint thing. So we put those either sides. And then we're going to wrap that around it. Doink. Look at that.
Thank you, Doctor.
Not quite a bandage. It's more of a brace, but whatever. This guy over here, dear God.
Perhaps Holmes will find a way to
Oh, perhaps you can do some fucking work, Doctor, for a change. You there! He has a head. Light bleeding. Bleeding will stop naturally. There's a horse on his leg! I think that's the problem here. We're not gonna chop the fucking head off, are we? Scaffold, plank, what? Oh, that there. Scaffolding. Press on the horse. Okay, we have everything we need to save this man. You there! Move! Right, get the saw. Oh, really? Oh, yes. Oh, I'm sawing it with my mouse up and down. Oh, yeah. Doink. The horse won't mind. He's dead. Right, can I save you now? Pull him to safety. Yep. Drag him. You stand guard, Watson. Make sure I'm doing it just right.
Thanks for your help.
Oh, you're welcome, my friend. Is everybody happy now? We're getting a loading screen. I think we're doing good. We let one person die. I really fucked up there. Maybe we could have got an achievement or something.
Holmes, it appears the police have arrested someone. Perhaps it is the person responsible for this disaster.
Maybe it was the closest living person they could find and they blamed it all on him. Right, save as many people as possible, complete.
Let me go. You're talking nonsense.
Insulting a police constable, eh? That's quite enough.
What's happening here, constable?
Mr. Holmes, this gentleman here is the fellow who built the scaffolding which collapsed and caused this accident.
That ain't true. How were you hurt? This hammer hit me on the leg.
How?
It flew out from the scaffolding I put up. When the damn thing collapsed, the hammer flew out and coshed me leg.
You were standing over there at the time.
Oh, aye. Yeah, that's right.
So it would not have been possible for him to bring the scaffolding down, Constable?
Perhaps it was poorly constructed.
Oh, right. Yes, of course. And what made it fall? Perhaps it was you, waving around that rotten stick of yours.
You'll wind up getting a taste of it if you carry on like this.
One moment, Constable. The scaffolding here has been entirely dislodged. It is unlikely that this disaster could have been the fault of this gentleman.
You tell him,
Allow me to inspect the area. And if you could possibly be of use, close off the surrounding section. Do not grant anyone access, nor allow them to leave. Is that quite clear?
Absolutely, Mr. Holmes.
This is my crime scene. Lock it down! Nobody leaves without my say-so.
This accident is a little unusual. I need to concentrate on the details. I must include all the participants in the accident sequence.
Righto, let's go find those clues. Come, Watson, be useful. Or don't. Up to you.
This cab hit the scaffold and caused it to fall.
Okay. And this one crashed? Yep. That's it. Doink.
A common phaeton. An uncommon location.
Yeah, in a horse window. A horse? Dead window horse. Fuck!
This horse was blinded by the flag, causing it to bolt into the window. The overturned lamps may well have caused the fire and explosion.
That sounds like a sound deduction, Holmes.
Celebratory bunting. A dead driver. Another victim of the explosion.
Damn it, I could have saved him! I could have saved everybody. I'd be a hero. They'd talk about me for days.
Might I ask you some questions regarding the accident?
No, you can't. Go away.
Suit yourself.
This jaunting car would be capable of travelling at great speed.
I'm sure it would. You there?
Might I ask you some questions regarding the accident?
It all happened so quickly. There was an explosion and my horse startled and threw me back against those wardrobes.
Dear God, you're going to have to pay for those. They're not cheap. Oh yeah, these.
Those wardrobes fell like dominoes.
They sure did. And
the pumpkins fell here after the sprung cart collided.
Oh no, what a mess. You there? Oh, we're going to get to talk to you.
Good day to you, sir. Would you mind answering some questions? I'm investigating this accident. Are you the driver of this cart?
Yeah. I was transporting vegetables from my farm to the London market.
I believe you. Accident.
What can you tell me about the accident?
I don't know. There was a collision. I felt the ground. I come over all dizzy.
I believe you. Collision.
What did you collide with?
That contraption up in front of me. He stopped all of a sudden and I tried to avoid him, but I wasn't quick enough.
I believe you. Sudden stop.
Do you have any idea what might have caused this cab to stop so sharply?
No, no idea.
I believe you. Moving on. Electricity. We can, yes, have a little plumb here. I thought they were gas, but this one's not. Doink that out, rip out those fuses. We have to deactivate the situation before anybody else gets hurt. I will not have anyone else die on my watch. Watson, test
this.
That's it. Well done. And safety resumes.
The old gas lamps in this square have been upgraded to electricity.
Damn right. Electricity is the future, everyone will know.
This technical cab was involved in this tragic accident.
It's a technical cab, is it? That's very swanky. Any more clues back here? We have 9 out of 13, everybody.
This is an absolute disaster.
It is. It's an absolute disaster. Don't worry yourself. Just stand up. Stay up there. I will sort everything. You.
Might I ask you some questions regarding the accident?
Please. Not now. I'm in shock.
He's clearly hearing voices in his head. Make the voices go away!
My poor leg.
Your poor leg. You're not out of it yet. I'm going to save the day, though. Hey! Would you fancy that? There's an axe in the roof. Can I get a look at that? Apparently not. Am I not supposed to have seen that? Well, I did see it. You can't make me unsee it, game. Bunting's down. Oh, yeah, that was a thing. Maybe now I can see it. Nope, still can't see it. Darn, 10 out of 13. I'm missing, oh yeah, the scaffolding. Let's get a better look at that.
This carriage was struck by the scaffold when it fell.
It was. Cool.
This mechanism played a part in the accident, I'm sure of it.
Cool.
This...
Is that enough? Oh. Do I have to reconstruct the situation? Is this right? Wait. Right, stop. Reset it. Stop. Behave. Calm yourself. Right. So I think the mechanism is going to fail. The counterweight will come down. And that's going to launch the platform. Yes? Is that not good enough? Oh, no. Oh, I get it. Right, what happens? Reset all of that. Right, good. The plank... Well, the plank falls. Makes the mechanism go nuts. Counterweight goes down. The platform goes up. Happy days? Okay, the pumpkin bangs into that, makes that go nuts, makes the counterweight go up, and the platform go up! Watch the sequence, we did it! Boink, boink! Oh no! Boink! Doink!
That's it?
Oh yes! Is that the last clue? That's the last clue! That's all we needed! And here's the axe, I can now see it for myself!
The axe was catapulted by the scaffold, and it landed here.
It did, and that made the bunting go down into the face of the horse. It crashed into there. That started a fire, which made the barrels explode on top of that. And that sudden stop made that side guy sudden stop. I can't remember. I know that made that horse over there stop. That made all those fall over. That made that guy stop, which caused this guy to crash in the first place. Which, no, that didn't. Fuck it. Anyway, map.
I believe I've enough information about this accident. Now let's recreate the sequence of events.
Yes, let's. So can I unselect everything? Right, here's what happens. That guy crashes into those. They domino over. That goes down. It causes that guy to stop all of a sudden. This guy goes nuts, goes over there. That makes that doink. And then that makes that fall down. Oh no! That makes this guy crash. This one smashes into there. And then that happens. No. Oh, I broke it. I broke it. Hang on. That guy is like, oh no! As that guy is dead on the ground. No? Maybe. That guy just falls over for the fun of it. Let's watch the sequence. Doink, zap. Doink, ka-doink. No, smash.
Include all the participants in the accident sequence.
Oh, I forgot to blow up the shop. Sorry. And that explodes. And that kill. Oh, wait. So, where's number 11? That explodes, blowing that guy up. And that guy falls over for the fun of it. Can I watch that? No, splat, zap. Bang, snap, wallop, crash, crash.
Include all the participants in the accident sequence.
Okay, this guy is going to go. He's going to slip on that water because it's very slippy. And that makes that guy swerve and spill his load onto that stuff that makes that go padoink. Makes that go down. Makes this guy, who's ahead, crash. Yes, we saw that happen. Yeah, makes that guy crash into that. No! Which makes that guy die splat. Makes this guy, holy smokes, smash and kaboom. Makes that guy die on the spot. No! Makes this guy crash into that. Makes the dominoes happen. Electrifying the water. I think that's it. And sizzle, bang, wallop, kabang, flop, and smash, boom. Boom, explosion, death, wallop, sizzle.
That's it.
Yay! Ridiculous, but yay.
The technical cab's sudden halt caused this disaster, but the lamppost fell down afterwards. So why did the cab stop?
Why did it stop? We must have a chat. Maybe he was getting hijacked? Oh, the guy had art. Oh, that's a tattoo. A tattoo of the dog tattoo. And his hands are palm.
This man was killed by electricity, as shown by the distinct mark on his hand.
He's got a gun. Weapon.
This man was armed with a revolver.
He's a
weapon,
thug,
I suspect.
So there's one more thing to see. Can I get a hint? Leg. Oh, his foot. Dirt on boots. What does that tell us? Find out. Yes, in the back seat. Easy paint.
Some kind of solvent. A piece of fabric drenched in solvent.
Was he getting hijacked?
A pneumatic hammer.
Another tattoo. Tattoo, dog tattoo. His hand, electrical burns once again. Liqueur, sticky liqueur. Dirt on boots. I think they were gonna... Okay.
Rasko, yes, I know him. He's a small-time local criminal.
And now he's dead. I think they were preparing a bomb to go do some bad stuff, but it kind of just broke on themselves. Broke on themselves.
A piece of fabric drenched in solvent. Some kind of solvent.
I'm missing a quest.
Some kind.
A deduction or something that's preventing me from going forwards. It's that whole map situation all over again. Right, go around the side. Nothing downstairs. Oh, the wheels.
There's a metal strapping.
Oh.
This crank has been turned.
Okay.
There's a metal strapping.
So I think when they drove on the water, the whole thing became electrocuted.
There's a metal strapping.
Yeah, there is. There's a drain. Is that drain important? No, it's not. Can I see this now? Still not quite a thing? Bollocks to you! Oh, whoa, there's a thing on the side here.
This cab was painted recently.
I can see electric railways.
This cab...
T-vision.
There is some text underneath the paint here. Could be important. I'll need to find a way...
Oh, the paint thinner. I can do this. Paint thinner. Give me the rag! Yes, this. Yeah, open up that first. Oh, take it with me. Why not? I was going to dunk it there, but no, that's fine. I'm having this. Go around the side. Thank you, Sherlock. Hurry up. And there it is. Right. We've done this before with a photograph. Underground electric railways. The subway. The tube. Company of London. Is that good enough?
Underground Electric Railways Company of London.
Dear God, I think that's told us everything. Maybe? The ground.
Mud. Oof, smells bad.
That's important. Sherlock vision. No. Number T. Water. Yes, I see the water. Something in the puddle. What's in the puddle? A wire. Oh, this is getting saucy.
There's some electrical wiring here beneath the manhole.
Right, okay. Where's that going to? That goes to over here. But that's not relevant, apparently. Under there, into this building. I'm coming in. I'm not even going to knock or anything. It's up here. We're going to find the culprits waiting, laughing. Let me in. It's okay, I'm Sherlock Holmes. I'm a private detective. No authority whatsoever. Oh, it's the lock situation. Double lock can be used in the same way as a single one. We know. Wow, I have loads more locks now. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. I don't know why they gave us so many picks for. Right, we're in. Oh. Someone's having a drink.
An open bottle of cheap wine.
They were waiting and having a drink.
A single glass.
So a single person did this. Smoke on the water. Women are now allowed to smoke in public, the court declares. Today, Magistrate Adox ruled that it is no longer a crime for a woman to smoke in the public area, in London at least. He then proceeded to discharge Mary Townsend, Edna Custer and Elsie Watkins. Three ladies who have been smartly arrested for smoking in Trafalgar Square. Dear God, the injustice in London is absurd. Open the window. Oh, they could see
there. I can see the technical cab very well from here.
Yes. And here we have a dynamo.
I've not seen such a device before.
It generates electrical charge. Oh. Where should I not tinker with this? Right. Click the switch. And that switch. All of the switches. Oh, there's too much power on that side. Maybe. I need to get both. Oh, you bastard. Right. Twiddle everything. Did it! It wasn't quite what I was trying to do.
Which affected the technical cab came from here.
Sorted, we're onto it. We know, but we need someone to arrest. Otherwise the police are gonna get that other guy. Oh jeez. Okay, well, there was one person here who I'm guessing was disgruntled about the smoking in public. I don't know. But the cart was made out of metal. It conducted all the electricity, and that's why the horse has stopped dead. Right, can I go talk to the police now? We have this covered.
Might I ask you some questions regarding the accident?
Please. No, leave him alone. He's in shock. Lololol. Officers, I've found it.
It's my poor leg.
Shut up about your leg, officer.
Holmes, I was looking for you. I have an idea about the accident.
Never mind. This one is murder.
What?
What?
You? You're a murderer,
you're
right?
Off your head.
Are you sure, Holmes?
Silence!
Oh, yes. A murder and an accident, because the killer, by electrocuting the cab, created this chaos. And so this multiple crash is now our great chance.
Our great chance? Of what, Holmes?
The culprit could not have planned for this to happen, don't you see? And it is possible that he is still here due to the prompt arrival of the police. Now, I see five men who could be our murderer. Let us take a look at the map.
Oh, back to the map. We love this map. Share your conclusions with the constables complete. Very close to the apartment, an ideal position to watch square, daily local worker. Okay. Or do I have to actually like click these guys? No? Wait, okay, that's one. Suspects found. Number two. Oh no, the guy at the back who wants nothing to do with anything. You there, he's in shock. Very close to the apartment, not very... Not wounded, could be a random pedestrian. Okay, moving along. There's the cord on the floor there. Wait, did I turn the electric back off again? I probably should. Around here. So yeah, he was clearly involved. Caused deliberate... injured. Yeah, he was injured. This guy, definitely not involved. Oh, the guy at the back there. He is looking very, very... Could be a random guy, distant, angry and nervous. I think it's him because he's angry and nervous. It's always those people, the angry and nervous people. Map of the accident. This man is beneath the window where the electrical device is. Perhaps he had the time to activate it before entering the street. This man appears to be a passerby. He is in the middle of the square, trapped by the accident. I'm going with that. Not a suspect. This man was not far from the flats. No, he's not a suspect. This guy, he was involved. He's not a suspect. This guy, not a suspect. This guy, I think it's him. This man is near the end of the square. He attempted to leave, perhaps because he did not wish to be seen by the police. He had the time to activate the electrical device and run away. Suspect! Confirm.
No, it wasn't like that.
Shut your face, it was definitely like that. Wait. This man is a driver. He was in the area of the accident took place and is one of the pumpkins. Is the one, it was one of, yeah, that, yeah. No, he's not a suspect. Shut your face, what do you want? Arrgh. Let's try it like that. Boink.
No, it wasn't like that.
Okay, the worker's a suspect as well. How about that?
That's it.
Yay! Constable! Constable! I have an idea. Where are you? Are you over there? I couldn't be further away. Right, brace yourself. It's a big one.
Constable, I suspect three people here. Take them to Scotland Yard for questioning.
As long as I don't leave empty-handed, all's good and well.
I know that look, Holmes. Have you found something new?
That's right. In order to trap the cab, the killer must have known the precise route it would take. Or even, that could suggest the cab must have set out not far from here, in this very street, perhaps.
Remarkable. Holmes, I'm terribly sorry, but I must go to the hospital now to help tend to the wounded.
I understand, Watson.
But don't forget our earlier discussion.
Oh, yes, Katie.
About Kate.
Yes, thank you, Jude Law, Watson. So, to Scotland Yard? Everyone seems to have gone home, and that car is... Yeah, we're leaving. Map. Boop-a-da-boop. Oh, we have stuff. Yep. Yep. Scotland Yard! Doink.
Oh, Mr. Holmes. We have a slight problem.
What happened?
One of the suspects, Mr. Reginald Butcher, has escaped. It was after we asked him to put his belongings in the evidence room. I'm sorry.
How did he escape?
He hit me in the face. Took me by surprise, you know, otherwise I...
Of course. That's all?
Just before he left the yard, he shouted, "Sorry, I'll come back later."
Sorry, I'll come back later?
He could have said that without punching me.
Is Inspector Lestrade here?
No, he will be absent for a couple of days. Can we keep this incident between us?
You let a suspect go? Yes, of course. Tell nobody. We pretend it didn't happen. Right, should we look at the other... Oh, do you want to talk to me? Or can I just talk to you?
Mr. Holmes?
Nope, don't want to say a thing. Love that you highlighted yourself. Let's see what we do have and we can make a deduction with that. So, number one.
A book. Karl Heinzen's 1848 Der Mord with a bookmark.
A Der Mord with the bookmark.
This terrible passage is apparently appreciated by Garrett.
If you have to blow up half a continent and create a bloodbath in order to destroy the barbarian's party, you can be deemed to possess neither scruples nor conscience. Anyone who would not happily sacrifice his own life for the honor of exterminating a million barbarians is not a true republican. I agree. Such clear-sightedness. Whatever that means. So someone's a bit of an extremist. Dear Mr. Garrett, we are obligated to inform you that despite your exploration, you are still in debt to a considerable sum of monies. We would request that you contact our payment service as soon as possible, otherwise we shall be obligated to involve the police in this unfortunate matter, Mr. Stewart, blah blah blah, Bank of England.
Electrical wires.
Oh, he's guilty. He's got electrical wires. He's a bit of an extremist and he owes people money. Number two.
Thick leather gloves. They're probably insulating.
Oh, like handling electrical wires. And a photograph.
My life has changed thanks to Pastor Gordon and my faith.
Faith, religion, extremist! Benjamin, my son, I'd be so pleased if you could join me and help lead our next charity banquet, which is due to take place on Sunday after the service. Your goodwill brings such joy, and I know that I may rely upon you. I remember how your life began in sin, your feeling rejected and alone in the world, and how you turned to the criminal path, but you found the strength within our Lord Jesus Christ. You can make the change. You became a good man. Our Lord will have mercy upon you. I shall always be happy to see you in our church, my son. God bless you, Pastor Gordon. Yep.
Whiskey. Of poor quality.
He's poor!
Murad. Quite a popular brand of cigarette.
He smokes! That doesn't tell me much. This guy.
This pen is an expensive one, but it isn't new.
Old money! Got a tin for the candy.
Reginald Butcher is fond of sweets.
Ooh, he's got a sweet tooth for murder! Mr. Butcher, we have the most excellent news for you. Please arrange to visit the hospital as soon as possible so that we may conclude this matter. P.S. Her condition is stationary. That's why the butcher left in a hurry, because he had to get to the hospital and he hadn't got time for this police mumbo-jumbo.
This letter from yesterday perhaps explains why Butcher was in such a hurry. At any rate, I now have an exact address.
Yay! Dear Mr. Butcher, your repeated absence, which is compounded by your delays with existing workload, simply cannot continue. You are responsible for a number of serious errors that your colleagues have found themselves compelled to rectify. We are sorry for this present situation, as you have always been an exemplary employee. We understand the complication of your personal situation, but if you are unable to correct your behaviour in the immediate future, we shall be forced to terminate your employment. The directors, Underground Electrical Railways. I don't know what this means.
Reginald Butcher had problems with his job.
Yeah, but that doesn't mean... Yes, he was shit at his job, but he was in the car that electrocuted itself. I don't think he's responsible for killing himself.
The initials MB.
Oh, no. Wait, I'm a dumb. He didn't kill himself. These are the people I found on the streets. Wait, if I'm so bad at my job, I'm going to kill my fellow employees. Therefore, I'm the only one left, and they can't fire me. Right. The deuce. Here we go. And let the clicking begin. Yay! Criminal in the past. Benjamin Fowler was a bandit when he was young, but has since changed his ways. More clues! Yep. Anarchist ideology. Anarchists operate the state, capitalism and market relations, but Thomas Garrett is in the debt to the bank. Yes, he is. More of these. Problems at work. None of them. None of them. We're done here. Let's go to the hospital, I think. Because we haven't got enough to talk to them yet. Or maybe we do. Let's have a chat. Let's not go to the morgue. It's a very sorrow place. Hey, guys.
Please, escort this suspect for interrogation.
Okay, I just meant to talk to him, but this will do.
Good day to you. My name is Sherlock Holmes, and I am assisting the police with their investigation.
I'm Benjamin Fowler, and I was arrested by mistake. I swear it.
You have not been arrested, Mr. Fowler. You are here as a witness.
Oh, but I saw nothing. I swear. Let me go.
No. Oh, we're going to get a look at you first. Right, your face. Let's get a look at your face. You got some bruising. Oh, you got an ear. Oh, you was a dog tattoo. But it looks like it's been kind of scourged out, like he was a member and got excommunicated. He was, because he found religion. Yes. And... Yo, callous hands. He's a manual worker. He is legit worker. And his leg is definitely fucked up. this hand. Yep, that's a hand. Smoker, because he got the yellow fingernails. Boop. Yes, got it right. Benjamin Fowler, a man of his 40s, is a manual worker. He is involved with the reconstruction work on the statue in the square, which explains his presence at the scene of the accident and his resulting leg injury. Mr. Fowler has a dog tattoo, a gang member's mark, which he attempts to hide. Yellow nails identify him as a heavy smoker. He is a religious man. Let's talk to him. Accident! Victim and acquaintance! Accident!
Could you tell me what you were doing at the scene of the accident?
I was working on the square's statue. I work for the council, I swear it.
I believe you. Electricity.
Do you ever work with electricity?
Yes, sometimes. I repair electric lampposts, but I'm not a specialist. I swear it. It's new, isn't it? And complex. And dangerous.
I understand.
Mr. Holmes, I know you're a great detective and you understand me, so please let me go. I know nothing. I swear...
Yes, you swear it. I know.
Shut up. Right, you work with electrical lamps like the one that fell over and electrocuted people, but you're not a specialist. You admit foul play and malice because you're too crap at your job. Victim acquaintance.
Mr. Fowler, does the name Rasco ring any bells with you?
First time I ever heard it, I swear.
Oh, is it? But the dog tattoo.
But your tattoo resembles his. You are in his gang, are you not?
No. It was a long time ago. Already forgot. I swear it. I just picked a few pockets for him when I was a young fellow. But I ain't proud of what I did. All my family, my parents, my brothers, dogs and cats all died when I was a lad. I wouldn't have survived otherwise.
I kind of believe him. It'd be too convenient for him to kill his fellow previous gang members. Right, this guy right here.
Please, escort this suspect for interrogation.
Bet you wish you spoke to me on the street now, huh, punk? I'm going to interview the shit out of this guy.
My name is Sherlock Holmes.
Thomas Garrett. Why am I here?
You are a witness to murder.
Of course. Well, it wouldn't be the first time that the police jailed an innocent man in order to close a case.
No one has been charged yet.
Yet.
You're not well, are you? Let's get a look at this guy. At the face. Covered in sores and bruises. He's a particularly ugly fellow. He is ill because he's coughing a lot. And he has a brooch, a badge. Anarchist. He's an anarchist. And he's got worn clothes. He's definitely poor. And he's dirty. Black stuff. Ciliosis? Wow, his hands are fucked. Electrical burn. Ooh, that's suspicious. Yes! Thomas Garrett is an aggressive person who wears a symbol of the anarchist. He dislikes the police and most probably all authority. It is obvious that he is poor and his clothes are old and worn. Mr. Garrett exhibits black smutrum throughout his clothing, which is symptoms of ciliosis. Garrett is ill. A specific burn upon his finger reveals that he must work with electricity. Tell me more. What, dear Juicy? Electricity.
Do you have any electrical knowledge?
How do you know about that? You a mind reader?
Yes.
There
sure.
are electrical wires amongst your belongings.
Clever. Yes. I teach electrics to my comrades, since I am currently without paid work. I'm self-taught, so we're not as dumb as you might think. And I don't want to work for bosses anyway.
I agree complicitly. Bosses are for people. You're ill.
You have a severe cough. Are you suffering?
It's only a cold.
It is not a cold. You have black sputum. Sputum. Yes.
Why not be honest with me? You are spitting up black fluid.
Yeah. Well observed. Yes. I have enough coal dust in my lungs to fuel an entire London district.
You were a miner then?
Since the age of 13, yes. At the Newcastle mines. 15 years of hell. Those were bloody times. But now it's over. I don't want to die in those holes like my father and my brothers did. In order to line the pockets of the rich.
He's got the black lung. What did you see?
Did you perhaps see anything in particular during or after this disaster?
Yes. I saw part of your bourgeoisie burn up and explode. It was spectacular.
Why did you remain in the square? Why not seek shelter?
Like the rest of the sheep, there were some wounded comrades, workers. I wanted to help them.
You did nothing, you just stood there and watched. You did bollocks all. Right, so we need to go to the hospital to see the last guy. Although we should put these clues together while we can. Let the clicking begin. Yep, here we go. Insufficient knowledge, the electrical trap for the technician cab was arranged by a professional. Thomas Garrett would not have sufficient knowledge. Sufficient knowledge? As Thomas Garrett teaches electricity, he would have sufficient knowledge to make the trap for the cab. Yeah, self-taught, but that could work. More clues! More clues. Yes! Not a specialist. Benjamin Fowler sometimes works with electricity, but he is not a specialist, and it is doubtful he would know how to create such a deadly trap. Must have found his work. Mr. Benjamin Fowler has sufficient knowledge to repair electrical lamppost, which could enable him to create a deadly trap for the cab. No, I'm going with not a specialist. Lampposts are one thing, dynamos are another. More clues. We're done here. And we're off. To the hospital. Goodbye, everybody. I'm Sherlock Holmes, and you've been fantastic. We're going to the hospital. Don't wait up, everybody. It may be a while. Goodbye. Oh, wait. Matt. To the hospital. Here we are at the hospital. We just magically appeared inside. No time for exterior shots. Oh, lovely drawing. I can tell Watson's been here. Wait, first person this up. Oh, that's going on the end credits of this video. I can just dock that there. I can frame that up nicely. There you go. Oh, you're going to have such lovely end credits. Got a book on the chair. I'm not going to read it. Not going to lie. Where is everybody? Rocking Horse. This is a children's
hospital.
I'm
apparently in the children's ward.
Yes, you are. But there's a lack of children. Oh, there's one. He's asleep. Let's not touch him. And this guy over here. Breathing apparatus. The iron chamber.
Mr. Reginald Butcher, I've come from Scotland Yard. Might we talk?
All right, but not too loudly. She's finally asleep.
Is she your daughter?
My pretty little Mel. She's very ill. Now look, I'm sorry I ran, but I had to see Dr. Blowberry today and the policeman wouldn't listen.
Don't worry, I understand now.
Doesn't mean you're off the hook, though. Your debt and sick children could have forced you to do some really dastardly things that you may regret later in life. He's got a badge. He's a railway worker. He would know the routes of the railway carriage. He was married. Wedding ring. He is still married. And his booty boots. Shiny shoes, recently cleaned. But he's got muddy trousers. We're not picking up on that. Child's bracelet. Daughter's gift. Yep. Obviously, because he has a child. That'd be dumb to think it's his decoration. Your eyes. Milky. Come on, what else do you want from me? Got the clean boots. Nice forehead, nose, mouth, tie. Oh, yes, this. Shabby, expensive waistcoat. Was once prosperous. Second-hand clothes. I'm going with one. Yeah, he was once with wealth. Yes! Reginald Butcher, a married man, holds the position of a railway worker. He is depressed due to the illness of his daughter, of whom he is extremely fond. His shoes are shining. They have no doubt recently been cleaned. His expensive waistcoat, now in a shabby condition, reveals that he was once previously a prosperous man. Mr. Butcher loves his daughter and is not ashamed to wear a child's bracelet to display his affection. Talk to me, Mr. Butcher, about your job.
What do you do for a living, Mr. Butcher?
I work at the office of the Underground Electric Railways Company.
Then you must be familiar with electrical devices.
I am indeed. Why do you ask?
It is of no consequence, but tell me, what are the reasons behind the problems you're experiencing at work?
Problems? What do you mean?
The letter from your job.
You have already received a written warning.
Yes. I'm often late to work. My boss doesn't understand my situation. It's difficult since my daughter became ill.
I see.
That's true. Technical cab.
Coincidentally, we found one of your company's cabs in the square where the accident occurred.
Really? Why was it there?
I have no idea. Do you?
No. But a week ago we had a technical cab stolen, along with its tools. Do you think that could be the one?
It's possible.
It was being ridden by thugs, so I think that's very true. So I think everyone's off the hook. Click everything. Really? Is none of these going to gel? Yes! Oh, no, I wasn't done with that. Bring it back. A complex trap. Reginald Butcher knows how to work with electricity because of his job, but that doesn't mean he'll be capable of creating such a deadly trap. Butcher's trap. Reginald Butcher knows how to work with electricity. It is his job. He would have been able to trap the cab and activate the device. Well, that is true. Like, he would know how to do that, but it doesn't mean he did it. So yeah, I think he's off the hook there. I think he'd be too preoccupied with his daughter than to waste time fighting crime. Think we're done with them? Oh, there's a letter here. Just gonna read your stuff, don't worry. Taking it with me. Mr. Butcher, I can confirm that we are willing to admit your daughter into the care of our hospital. You will be responsible for the travel expenditure, naturally taking all appropriate precautions due to her delicate state of your daughter. Additionally, you must attend any accommodation costs and all medical attention. The final bill cannot be summarized within this letter. It will depend, of course, upon your daughter's condition, but I must warn you that the sum may be considerable. Oh dear.
Admission file at Karolinska University Hospital in Stockholm.
Is this the lovely lady? Judith.
Mr. Butcher's wife.
She's dead. 1885?
Mr.
Yeah. Is this these clues? Am I done with that? We're not done with that, apparently. Well, what more do you want from me? The black band.
A young woman lost her life.
Back in the day, you were never like, you was sending a letter of, well, bad news of condolence of death or stuff like that. It'd be a black banded letter. So that's kind of along that line. Oh, sir. Wait, clues first in case I could provoke a new talk. Bip-a-dip-a-dip. Oh, yep, there we go. That's why we do this. Butcher's problems. Reginald Butcher has problems at work due to the time off he has taken to visit his seriously ill daughter. More clues. None of them. Let's talk to the guy again. Mr. Butcher, I have some more questions to ask you about your lovely wife. Who's dead? Did you kill her?
Can she be cured?
It'll take a long time, but I'm confident that we'll win this fight. I can't bear to think otherwise.
Yes, it's probably just a question of money.
What are you talking about?
Oh, what
it's
am I talking?
It's a question of willpower, and my daughter will win.
Yeah, and the treatment of Meryl Butcher. Yeah, I'm onto you.
I do hope so. Although the treatment at the Karolinska University Hospital is very expensive.
Ah,
Yeah.
Yeah, it's our only hope. Thanks to the good Dr. Blowberry, she finally has a bed. We're going out next week. It's our last chance. Do you have children?
Yes. I have a daughter too.
Kind of. It's kind of my daughter, kind of not my daughter. It's a long story. I killed somebody. Let's leave it
at that. We'd sacrifice our lives for our children, would we not?
Yes. Of course, yes.
Okay, do I have to make a deduction now? Oh, the notes. Medical notes of the lady, 12
Meryl
years
Butcher.
Old. Yep, is that all we want to get out of that? Heart murmurs, lung trouble. Yeah, she's fucked. Okay, we've interrogated everybody. I'm not really sure where we stand at this point. I think the gang's stealing the wagon. Wow, that's creepy as hell. Why is it burnt? Oh,
I'm apparently in the children's ward.
Yeah, we already observed that. Do I need to, like, literally see more of it? The book card. We've seen that before somewhere. Let's go back to the accident area and look at the technical cab. Londidium! Can you tell me anything more about where you came from? Oh, shit's loading. Pneumatic drill. It's not telling me anything. Okay, so we needed to work out where the cabbie came from so we can go back down the road and see what we can see. Although we can't go too far because of this roadblock. The tea has appeared. Nice top hat, bro. Oh, here we go. Now we're in business.
Fresh paint, but from something else.
Muddy footprints?
Mud. Oof, smells bad.
And barrels.
There was a collision here. The technical cab collided and stopped here.
Okay. Oh, so that had the railway worker men, they're riding the cab like normal, they get hijacked, oh no, and they crash. The gangsters get on it and then they take it down the road and then they die unwittingly.
The lock was forced.
We're going in. Right, investigating music is active. Snake rests and conspiracy. In the district of St. Victor, while in the act of demolishing an old house, masons have uncovered a nest of snakes which has spawned upwards of 100 squirming reptiles. Dear God, no! These reptiles did inhabit the bottom of a well long since dried up. In the middle of the snake's nest, there was the skeleton of a child who had likely plunged down the well to his or her death. Surprisingly, the skeleton in question was still holding a red Morocco portfolio, much disintegrated apart from one legible strip of paper which read, "Do not reveal the plot." Okay. Is that relevant to anything? I don't have a clue what that means. Oh. That's fine. That's the door just banging. Bagpipes. Got like an odds and jobs kind of thing going on. Okay, let's go around the back. Nothing on the board. Lockpick time. I don't really enjoy these, to be honest. They're just kind of a... Oh, they waste time. Yeah, we're in business. Boom!
A workshop. Saleable items are produced here.
I can already see on the floor the muddy footprints. Something's over here. It's a trap door.
It looks as though the carpet was placed here intentionally.
Let's get a look then. Oh, shock horror, there's a hole in the floor.
An old access point to the sewers.
Okay, we're going down. Okay, we're in the sewers now. Isn't this lovely? Yeah. Oh, look at that. It's a wet and gooey wall. Is there anything in particular here? This is a little walk around, I guess, and see what we can see. I'm sure something's going to jump out at us. Neither murder us or present itself as a clue. Anything in particular this way? Oh, we got stuff muddy? No, muddy. Everything's bloody muddy down here. It's a sewer. Should I have Holmes vision on? Meh. Let's go the other way. Whenever presented with a left or right decision, I always pick the wrong way to go. Just to make it a bit longer, it seems. Tree, mud, ladder. It's not very extravagant down here now, is it? That door's not going to open. It's got junk behind it. Or maybe this is just to serve as like a maze. I thought I heard a sound of a door opening. I hear some creaking. Wow, there's like... Wait, is that carts and stuff over there? I want to... Oh, there's carts here. Why is there carts in the sewer? You can't flush them down the toilet. Oh, and some weird sounds from over there. I want to get over here. Wow. Who wants to go skinny dipping? I think if you did, you'd come out with extra somethings. London sewer. And that's kind of true. They did kind of... As you'd think a sewer, why put effort into it? But they kind of did put some effort into it. You know, with extra detailing and ironwork and stuff. Oh! What does that do? Is that going to drain the water? Ew, that's kind of gross. Wait, how low can you go? I'll just think at the bottom there'd be like a big thick bit of shitty mud. So one more. Oh, this. What does this do? It opens the door. Oh, we're not going down there, are we? Jeez, in this clothes. Go back to Baker Street and put some wedding boots on first. Think what Kate would say. Sherlock, you stink. Oh, we're walking in the muddy bit. Oh, that's horrible. Alright, we're going to push this. And, yep, slide it along that shitty sludge. Horrible, horrible stuff. Are you quite done, Sherlock? That should do, that should do. That's more than enough. Right, we're going to flood the place again. Yeah, let go, let go. I bet it stinks as well. Really would stink. Oh, and this ladder itself would be covered in slimy shit. Oh. As soon as we're done in here, the better. Go, Sherlock. Go, 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 go. Hit the switch. Yes, could you go any slower? Thank you very much. And doink, doink. Let's go for a half fill. Feeling good with a half fill. Here it comes. Jump, 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 jump. Is that good enough? Yeah, it is. Whee. So which way now? Balance beam. Oh God, we're going to do our balancing skills. And if we fail, we fall into shit. I'm tempted to let myself fall just to see what happens. But that would slow the episode down and I'd rather keep momentum going. So we're going to be doing this. And as before, as I said in previous episodes, this really hurts my brain. Trying to control both balls at the same time. It's all about ball control, you see. You have to handle your balls. You know, if you fuck with one too much, it's going to really balls up. And you don't want it to balls up, because that way you got to start again. I can't talk crap. We did it! So now this can go all the way to max. Max it out. Ooh, yeah. That's good for reasons. What's that do? Yay! Oh, easy peasy. Oh, I preemptively got that puzzle in one, it would seem. Oh, that has to come towards me. We're not quite done yet. So I need to lower the water yet again. Oh, this is tedious. All right, to zero, please. Thank you very much. And then I can go down this ladder, push that to the middle, and then escape. Maybe. I don't think that's the case, actually. I think I messed up. I think this is the halfway point. It is. Okay, that has to come over to this. All right, can I jump? Oh, jeez. Right. The long way round it is. Come on, Sherlock. Get on with it. You know, Watson's elsewhere, talking to nurses, having a great time. And you're poking around in the sewers, looking for a shitty clue. That, oh, what's that do? Oh, that's going to swiggle swaggle. The ladder. Oh, great. I'm glad I saw that now, because that would have really pissed me off later. Right, and down the ladder we go. Because when we push the thing at the bottom, that's going to line up with the ladder perfectly. And there's a break in the middle of the ladder. So, goody. Wait, it's not as easy as that, is it? Maybe it is. Get back here. Man, we're wading through shit. Not just any shit, 1800s London shit. This is like the worst kind of shit you can get because there'd be zero treatments whatsoever and the crap they're eating is horrible. And we're done. Right, back up the top. I might jump cut this a little bit just to speed up progression.
Boom!
Okay, the water's rising once again. That's coming up to the midway mark. I can jump on this, go down the ladder like a boss. Oh yes, look at me go, working it like a champ. Now here's the floater. And we jump on the floater and onto the ladder. We done? I'm guessing we is not done because... Oh, this one's blocked. But we're going to swiggle this and there's a walkway that will come across. No, it's a doorway that opens. Even better. Pump it up achievement unlocked. Yes, in the bag. Loving it. There's a safe over there. Oh.
A red powder. Given the circumstances, most probably iron oxide. Or just rust.
Or just rust.
Magnesium strips.
And there's some wire. I think it's the beginnings of magnesium? I don't know. This way is the bridge to get back across. Goody. And over here, the gang, they were breaking into the vault.
So, it was the goal of Rasko's gang to rob the bank.
Yes! It's a bank robbery. This is far more exciting than a standard vault of a square robbery.
The thieves have opened almost all of the deposit boxes. They must have taken a great many valuables.
I'd feel a bit uncomfortable being found in the vault at this very moment. Oh, they cut through. So that drill, there was a pneumatic drill on the back of the carriage.
The thieves have opened almost all of the deposit boxes. They must have taken a great many valuables.
So where are the valuables now? That cart was empty. Holmes vision. Does anything stand out? No. That's gone green. That means it's done. The ladder. That's gone green. That's done. The door.
This vault belongs to the Bank of England.
And a magnificent door it is. Hey! Oh, I didn't see you before. We have a map. Fantastic. Can we have a good look at this?
An old map of the sewers with a red cross.
Oh, X marks the spot and all that jazz. Dollar sign. Space to put the dollar sign. Okay, let's go and investigate that, shall we? Oh, yeah, space to hide the map. Well, on our way, we have an accord. And off we go. This is kind of cool. I like bank heists. I think they're clever and fun. And this is fun. I'm liking this. Like, okay, the whole chain reaction thing was pretty fun as well. But I like where this is going. Wait. Okay, so it's the left coming up out of here. Is it going to give me an easy left? Through that door there? Oh no, through that way there. Here we go, we're in business. Just kick it down, Sherlock. Yeah! Shoulder barge of doom and destruction. Well, there's... Is this where the stuff was? Got a tin.
All of the licorice has been eaten.
One of them had a taste for sweeties in the police station.
Metal rings. They're used to hold the barrel in one piece.
Okay, and the cigarettes? These are cheap ones?
That's a popular brand of cigarette.
If we can match the same cigarettes and the sweets to the guy in the police station, we have a really strong suspect.
A banknote. Dry, so it hasn't been here very long.
And a hammer? No, we've done that.
This cigarette stub is dry. It was discarded fairly recently.
Okay, we're done with the cigarette. Oh, an action?
This cigarette stub is
dry.
Oh,
the smell.
The tobacco's aroma is still strong. It's sweet and nutty.
Sweet and nutty. Just the way we like it in the sewers. Sweet and nutty. We're done in here. Back my face out. We're not quite done, it seems. You know when you're done because it goes green. Banknotes. Barrel.
These barrels are empty and unsealed. The thieves used these barrels for the loot, which they then threw into the water. I need to warn Lestrade about this.
So the loot's in the water and it's going downstream back to the police station. And go, Scotland Yard! Oh, you. I'm not talking to you. Look at your face. You deserved it. You were disgraced in the force. I spit in your direction. Are we done it? This guy. Sweets.
Reginald Butcher is fond of sweets.
Reginald Butcher. Oh, the butcher.
Reginald Butcher is fond of sweets.
Yes, he is. That's an expensive pen.
The initials MB.
His daughter's hanky. But he likes sweets, but then the other cigarettes. Cigarettes.
Murad. Quite a popular brand of cigarette.
They're the same cigarettes. If I could smell them, I bet they'd smell sweet and nutty. And this guy with the wire.
Electrical.
Oh, I'm pretty sure it's the butcher guy with the kids, not Fowler. But then Fowler has the same cigarettes, but if it's a popular brand... I didn't see this drawer!
The belongings of the victims, Rasko and his acolyte.
Oh, here we go.
Rasko is fond of licorice. Huh. The licorice was found both at the sewers and amongst Rasko's belongings.
That's important for reasons.
A Webley revolver.
A Webley! Nothing says give me your weapons and your money and your life like a Webley.
A normal pocket knife.
I saved that one, didn't I?
A standard deck of playing cards.
Classic mob guy. Gun, cards, a flick knife. Ooh.
A police report about Rasko. He's only a minor criminal.
I'm taking it all the same. Here we go, reading time. Mauricio Alfredo Vincent, also known as Rasko, leader of the small local gang whose members can be identified by a gang's motif, a dog tattoo. The gang has been involved in frequent violence, robbery, pickpocketing, etc. Fan dabby dozy. Clues! Here we go. Underground worker Reginald Butcher works for the Underground Electric Railways Company. He could be familiar with the layout of the sewers from where the bank was robbed. That sounds very plausible, and we have a connection. Butcher's love. Reginald Butcher is not a criminal. He has a beloved daughter who is ill and needs her father. He would not risk becoming involved with bandits, but his hopelessness. Reginald Butcher needs urgent medical care for his daughter. Because of this, he has contacted the Rasko gang and helps them to rob a bank. I believe that to be the case. We have some more clues. Boop-a-doop-boop-boop-boop. Who's this? Robbed bank. The Bank of England was robbed by the Rasko gang. It was the bank where Thomas Garrett has a large debt. Oh! Just an anarchist. It's not anarchist ideology to rob a bank. They prefer to destroy. That's kind of true. Anarchists and the bandits. Thomas Garrett allied himself with the Rasko gang in order to take vengeance on the Bank of England. No, he's just an anarchist. Take that, Thatcher. In the future. Future Thatcher. Oh, here we go. Evil plan. Somebody knew about the bank robbery and managed to kill the members of Rasko's gang immediately afterwards. I think that's very possible. So the last one, bank robbery and the tattoo. Here we go. Rasko gang. Benjamin Fowler is connected with the Rasko gang. He has the gang's tattoo but has made an attempt to remove it. We have a connection. Fowler's new life. Benjamin Fowler was once a member of the Rasko gang, but that is all now in the past. Always a criminal. Bandits like Benjamin Fowler never change. His work for the town might be a cover for his crimes. No, I'm pretty sure it's a new life. This isn't getting us anywhere, is it? Okay, so if we say Butcher does know how to do the trap. Yes, it's all coming together. Mr. Butcher is a murderer. Mr. Butcher is a murderer. Reginald Butcher helped the Rasko gang to rob the bank and then killed them for the money. Condemn Reginald Butcher. Reginald Butcher is a dangerous criminal who not only robbed the bank but also killed all the accomplices. He must be imprisoned or absolve Reginald Butcher. Reginald Butcher's daughter is seriously ill. Because of this, he is forced to rob the bank before killing his accomplices in order to take the money necessary for her treatment. Let him go. That might save his daughter's life. Oh, for fuck's sake. Why give me such moral decisions? If I condemn him, I'm basically condemning his daughter to death. Yes, he did a bad, he robbed a bank, but they're insured, I guess. He also murdered people. So yes, he killed the bank robbers, but they're bad people. So maybe that's not such a faux pas, but members of the public did die. Is the life of his daughter worth more than the lives of like 7 people who died? Oh, the goody two-shoes in me wants to condemn him. Perhaps it's not too late to get some good out of this shitty situation. Oh, I really can't decide.
Yes, Daniel.
Quick fire questions. Man robs a bank, kills his accomplices, and takes the money for himself and kills loads of the members of the public. Should he go to prison? However, the money was for his dying child. If he goes to prison, she will die too. Should he be spared so that she may live?
No.
Thank you very much. There we have it. We're condemning him. You got to do what your mama tells you to do. Mama told me to condemn this guy. So I'm absolved of all moral choices. Right, we're doing it. Boop, boop.
Mr. Holmes?
Mr. Butcher, say goodbye to your daughter. We are arresting you for robbery and murder.
What? You can't do that. What happened to my girl?
You should have thought about that.
You monster. Even if it were true, what would a bank's money be worth against the life of a child? I love you, Merrill.
Murder is never proof of love. Now please, come with us.
I feel really bad on the inside. Chain reaction. Reginald Butcher committed murder and robbed a bank for his personal gain. There can be no excuse. He should have found an alternative solution to his problems. He must be imprisoned. Whoa! Only 16% of people made the same moral choice. We found all the clues, though. Oh. Oh my god, am I a bastard? Well, no, my mum told me to do it, so yeah, I'm fine. Anyway, boom! Accepted. And accepted. Well, that's an episode right about there. Thank you so much for watching, everybody. It was a really cool episode. I would love to get your feedback in the comments below about what you think I should have done, who you think really was the bad guy at hand here. The good thing about these cases is that it doesn't actually tell you if you're right or wrong, although so far I'm pretty sure we're spot on the money. Anyway, on that bombshell, we're done here. Thank you for watching. Rate, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next episode. Goodbye, everybody. Percent of the world agreed with you.
Good.